A very warm welcome in the class of Mathematics 3. We are in the module of Propositional Logic. Today our topic is normal forms. We are going to discuss here two types of normal forms, conjunctive normal form and disjunctive normal form. Myself Rupak Bhattacharjee, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, JIS College of Engineering. So, the prerequisites for this particular class is the concept of proposition, which is already delivered to you in the first class, that the statement or proposition is a declarative sentence which is having the truth status as true or false. Then we have discussed the logical connectives, and these logical connectives are also very much important in the whole discussion of this topic. We are actually talking about disjunction, conjunction, negation, implication, biconditional and others. And the next prerequisite for this discussion is the construction of truth table. And finally, we need the assistance of algebraic formulas for the logical connectives. So these are actually the prerequisites of today's class, and all these are elaborately discussed in the previous classes. Today, the new thing what we are going to incorporate is that firstly, if you concentrate on the topic name, that is conjunctive normal form and disjunctive normal form. But one thing is common in them, that is normal form. So first of all, we have to know that where we need this normal form and why we need it. Actually, this normal form is not a new term, because you have used this term normalization, normal form. These are also in matrix. Actually, the fact is that we can determine the logical equivalence of two expressions, capital P and capital Q, by comparing truth tables. We can create some truth table of them and we can compare them. But it is very much clear that the process is tedious when the number of variables increases. So what we can do, we can transfer the expression of P into P dash and expression of Q into Q dash, such that obviously you have to follow some standard procedure, such that comparing this P dash and Q dash, we can get the conclusion of comparison of P and Q, and we can state whether P and Q are logically equivalent or not. That standard procedure, after applying it, the form what we are getting are known as normal forms or canonical forms. Now there are two types of these normal forms. One is disjunctive normal form, and another one is conjunctive normal form. In short, the first one we are write DNF, and the second one we are writing as CNF. Now, before entering into the procedure for obtaining CNF and DNF, we want to give some basic idea on some related terms. That is, when we are taking the propositional variables, suppose small p, small q, small r, etc., then obviously we can consider their negations also. Suppose negation of p, negation of q, negation of r, etc., then a product of these propositional variables or their negations, means p, q, p, r, p, negation of q, anything you can take, they are called elementary product. So as for example, we can say that it is p conjunction negation q, it is one elementary product. P conjunction negation q conjunction r, it is also another elementary product, and so on, because it follows the formula or the definition of elementary product. Immediately one question will come, that what is elementary sum? Product we are using for this, sum we are using for this. So elementary sum is nothing but a sum of propositional variables and their negations. And for example, we can give that P disjunction Q elementary sum, negation of P disjunction Q disjunction negation of R elementary sum, because they are nothing but the combinations of the propositional variables or their negations. So we made the idea clear about what is elementary product and what is elementary sum. What we will do using this? The definition tells us that a logical expression is said to be in disjunctive normal form if it is sum of elementary products. Keep this information or clue in your mind, that DNF is sum of products. That means it will give you something where these are all sums, but the sums will be for products. Keep this structure in your brain. And vice versa, if you think for CNF, CNF is nothing but a logical expression. If you want to see, I can write a logical expression is said to be in conjunctive normal form if it is product of elementary sums. So what we are getting? It is nothing but having the structure of product, and the product takes place between two expressions where these are of elementary sums. So this is the very basic fundamental structure of CNF and DNF. Now coming back to DNF, what is the procedure for finding out or obtaining the DNF? So for the first problem, first let us make you clear the procedure of obtaining DNF. Obviously from a logical expression. So what is the procedure of this? First, eliminate all implication, biconditional logical connectives by the connectives of negation, disjunction, conjunction. Why? Because in your DNF, you are allowed to take elementary constituents, and these elementary constituents are made up by negation, conjunction and disjunction. These two are not allowed. So you have to eliminate them. This is our first step for finding out DNF. Now the second step tells us that we can eliminate negation before sums. Not we are going to eliminate all the negations. We are going to eliminate negation before sums and products. Why? By double negation, means you know that negation of P is P. By double negation, or by, you know, by one rule, you can eliminate this negation sign, or rather you can insert this negation sign into the logical expression, that by using De Morgan's law. Okay. And finally, the third step is we have to use the distributive law. We have to use the distributive law until a sum of elementary product is obtained. because our target is to find out DNF, disjunctive normal form. So this is our target, where this will be of like this pattern. So until a sum of elementary products is obtained. So this is the procedure of obtaining DNF. Now we need one example to make it clear. So we can take the example of firstly a very simple one. DNA of P disjunction, negation of P implies Q disjunction, Q implies negation of R. It is not in disjunctive normal form because these symbols are there, as well as it is not at all the sum of products. So we have to follow the rule what we have just learned, that how to find out this one. So we can start it from this line, and we can write it as, if I just don't write this one and we are taking this one starting from this line, then what will be here? It will be P, because our target is to first remove this. So P here we are applying this. Q implies negation of R. We are removing this implication by implication law, in such that negation of Q disjunction negation of R, because A implies B, actually logically equivalent to negation of A disjunction B. So one is removed. Now, in the next line, P disjunction, our job is to remove this implication sign now. So this one implies this. So negation of negation P disjunction, this whole thing will be coming. So what we get, negation of negation P is P, then disjunction, then the whole thing like this, that is Q okay. But it is true that in this line all these implications are removed, but the thing is not in desired DNF form. So in the next line, what we can do, P disjunction, P disjunction, Q disjunction, negation of Q disjunction, negation of R. And in the next line, as all are disjunctions, we have removed all the brackets, and in the next line we can write P disjunction Q, because P disjunction P is same, P disjunction Q disjunction negation of Q disjunction negation of R. So this is our desired DNF. Now for this simple problem, if this takes this much of lines, then if you are asked to find out by property. You have to find out the DNF of find negation of P disjunction Q biconditional P conjunction Q. Try to find out the DNF of this problem in your own practice time, obviously by using properties. The question next comes that if a small problem requires this rigorous practice of properties, is there any alternate way? Yes, there is one alternate way to find out DNF, and this is nothing but stated by a problem: find DNF for P disjunction Q implies negation of P conjunction R. So how many variables you are getting? P, Q and R, 3. So we are going to construct the truth table of this one. I am not going to show the elaborate calculation of this truth table because of time. We have to cover the CNF also, but you please do the sequential steps for finding out the truth table. So what we are getting here, P, Q and R, and we are taking it P disjunction Q implies negation of P conjunction R. So this truth table we have to construct. We know that there will be 8 combinations because 2 to the power 3 is 8, and these 8 combinations are 1 1 1 1 1 0. You can write it in this direction or you can write it in this direction, up to your choice. But one thing we have to make it sure that all possible combinations must be there. And what is left? Finally, 0, 0, 0 is left. So, if you perform this truth table, the result what you are going to get is please pardon me because these are not straight lines, but it should be the straight line. I am practicing it to make it straight. Okay, so after getting the truth table of this one, we will get it as 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. It is not at all any magic. It is I am taking for this class as an information, because this is not our prime target to find out truth table. Our target is to find out DNF. But keep one thing in your mind, in your exam time, you need to do this calculation also for the truth table before finding out the DNF. Now, from truth table to DNF, the formula tells us that as here in row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, row 4, row 7 and row 8 gives you 1 and the others are 0. That means the formula is satisfied by the truth assignments in these rows. The rule tells us that the DNF will be then please concentrate. Negation of P Q R disjunction. Before going into the next parts, please look at this from where it coming. This one corresponds to this. This zero means negation of P, one means Q, this one means R. So go to this one, that means this one, what will be the element over here? Zero, negation P, then zero, negation Q, then one, that means simply R, then again disjunction for the last one, negation of P, negation of Q, negation of R. So this is the desired disjunctive normal form for this problem. Look at this, all are elementary product and these are sum of elementary product for this particular problem. So this is easy. The concept is that you have to keep this information also in your mind, that it is not at all guaranteed that it will be unique. You can get some more DNA for a single expression, as well as it is very much clear to us that the DNA can be calculated by various processes, not only the unique process by using properties, we are getting it also by truth table. So obviously it is clear to you that what are the things remaining. We need to discuss something now for CNF and its calculation, that means how to get. The process is same, the methodology is same, just the idea is reversed. So if you have to find out CNF of Is it clear? How many variables are there? 3. And we get some expression where negation, disjunction, conjunctions are present, but not in the desired form what we need. We need it product of elementary sums. So how to do the problem? Next line. So what we do, that we are keeping this Q as it was, then this one, then P R, then this one. What we are doing, we are absorbing this negation, because it was discussed in that particular part that negation is going to be inserted within bracket. So what we are doing, we are making this negation inserted within this calculation, and this negation of P disjunction R conjunction negation of Q, because this negation sign is inserted, so there will be a negation as well as there will be also a negation. Now in the next line, what we can do, Q disjunction P conjunction R, up to this there is no problem because this is elementary sum, this is also elementary sum, sorry, elementary product, and we can treat it also as elementary product. Then this one, then this negation is inserted for this one, so it is negation of P okay, from which we are writing this negation of P disjunction R is negation of P conjunction negation of R. You know that it is by De Morgan's rule. So if I have inserted this one also here, I must change this So this is not the right thing. Right thing will be this one, not this. Okay, because De Morgan's law enters this symbol as well as make this thing reversed. That means conjunction to disjunction and disjunction to conjunction. So this one will be this with negation of Q. That means no alternation. So in the next line, what we see, we can write it as Q P Q R. Can you tell me the rule? The rule is simply distributive rule. Okay, this one, then negation of P disjunction negation of Q conjunction negation of R disjunction negation of Q. So look at this, what you see, sum elementary sums, product, so it is nothing but product of elementary sums means CNA. We got this, and using the properties, so simultaneously one question will come that if I want to find out CNA by truth table, then how to do it? So if our target is to find out the truth table for this one, to find out the CNF, then what we can do, like the last problem, we can construct the truth table for P, Q and R and this statement. So it is P, Q, R and this statement. So here also the combinations are very important. You don't repeat it, you don't skip it. And by performing the truth table concept, the truth table, what we are getting it here as 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. The same problem actually we have taken for the CNF and DNF. But in the last case for DNF, we have concentrated on 1. But here we are concentrating on the zeros, that is row 1, row 2, row 3, row 5 and row 6. All are 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. So we have to now consider 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, then, and we have to write the equivalent CNF of this one as 1, 1, 1, that is P, Q, R conjunction, 1, 1, 0, P, Q, negation of R conjunction P negation of Q R conjunction 1, 2, 3, this 0 P negation of Q negation of R conjunction five terms, so it will be the last one is negation of P. Last one means 1, 2, 3, 4, this one, negation of P, Q, negation of R. So this is our desired CNA from truth table. So, ultimately in this class may be a little long, but we have discussed the concept of CNF, the concept of DNF, the concept or the technical procedure to find out CNF, DNF and etc. Very much things. So, please take your time to concentrate on this particular part. So, finally, we are going to give you some references and these references are like this because we have taken this materials to make this particular lecture and there are also some assignments where you have to find out the truth table and then equivalence, then normal forms, conjunctive normal form, disjunctive normal form and so on, and you can use also both the properties for your practice, both the approaches basically for your practice. And then obviously you can choose your system as per your comfort zone. So finally, I want to thank you all for your kind patience. Happy listening, happy learning.